Hello there, I'm Ralphie and welcome to my rapid reviews of beverages. And on this occasion, I am reviewing briefly for you one of the most instantly recognised and globally available beers in the world. It's Guinness and it comes from Ireland and it's brewed in Dublin and it has been getting brewed since 1759. I have a can of Guinness and I have a bottle of Guinness. Both the same brand, but they have different flavours. And this is where my emphasis in this review is going to be. If you want to know more about the history of Guinness, just go on to Wikipedia. You'll find plenty of information. A lot of it is produced primarily in cans, available from many bars around the world, particularly in Ireland, where they will claim that it's the best version you can get is in Ireland, right? But in my opinion, as a Scotsman, this isn't true. And I'll tell you why. Because everything tastes better psychologically in the place it's made. Now, when you're in Ireland, in an Irish bar, and you've got such a good atmosphere, and a bit of what they call the crack, and all the rest of it, and that one marvellous sense of humour, depending on which bar you go to, of course. That's why the Guinness will taste better. The can, by the way, if you give it a brief shake, has a little solid object inside. This is the draft version. It's got a cleaner, smoother taste. And just to confirm, Guinness is a stout that's made from a combination of roasted, malted barley and unmalted barley with some hops and yeast. The yeast, by the way, contributes significantly to the flavour. When you pull the ring pull on the can of Guinness, you will hear a kind of whooshing sound inside. And that is the widget being activated. The widget contains nitrogen and it partially gases the contents of the beer, which means that when you pour it, you get a good head on it and it has a certain amount of freshness and zestiness to it. When you're pouring, pour carefully. Do not pour from a height because you don't want to create too much of a head on your beer. The other version is in the bottle. The bottle does not contain a widget. The bottle contains a more traditional style, more flavoursome and heavier style of Guinness. So in fact, you have two beers with the same name, but they've got different flavours and they've got different appearances. Right, now, as you can see, I've been a little bit hasty in pouring this and all the excitement, but hey ho, it'll soon settle down. The main thing is the glass isn't overflowing and wasting that valuable, precious liquor. I don't know if you can see, I'll hold it up closer, but the head on the draft Guinness is a little bit whiter than the head on the bottled Guinness. I'm going to focus now on the flavours because they have different flavours. The can of Guinness and generally the draft Guinness that you buy in bars around the world has got a milder flavour and it's more drinkable. In other words, you can drink more of it and you won't feel as full up as you will when you're drinking the traditional style, which is slightly more bitter and slightly more flavour ranged. With the draft, and forget the smell, you're not going to get much smell off it. It smells mildly of yeast and hops and beer. It's very clean. It doesn't hang around in the palate. You're getting the roasted malted barley. There's just a hint of sweetness to it, but not too much. It's fresh in the palate, clean in the palate. It doesn't hang around and you can drink a lot of it and not get too pished too quickly. This is one of the main advantages of Guinness. It means that if you're not pished when you're out and about, you're less likely to be robbed and mugged wherever you are. Or getting your drink spiked with chemicals. Hey, it's modern times, I'm just letting you know. Is this settling down a wee bit? I'm going to get a great big creamy nose here. But I've got to go for it anyway, I can't hang around with this review. The traditional Guinness from the bottle, called the original, I highly recommend that you find yourself a bottle if you know the draft style. Because you'll immediately see the same flavour but delivered differently and a little more dramatically from the bottle contents. Sharper, more citrusy, more astringent on the palate. There's an additional sweetness to the bottled Guinness, which is counteracted by the additional flavours coming from the cereal and also that additional yeastiness. It's also slightly more grain citrus. And when you have them side by side, that is the most dramatic way of seeing the difference between them. Go and check it out for yourselves. Don't just take my word for it. I'm just an alcoholic beverage reviewer that sits in a moldy old building somewhere in the Irish Sea and tells you all about it. And by the way, I'm happy to share. I hope you've learned something. And furthermore, I hope you have a lovely, lovely day wherever you are, whatever you're doing and whatever your circumstances. So there you have it.